Hello, and welcome to our daily reflection in Lent. Today, our focus is on prayer, and in particular, perseverance in prayer. Our reading today is from Luke 11, verses 5 to 10. Perseverance in prayer. And he said to them, "Which of you who has a friend will go to him at midnight and say to him, 'Friend, lend me 3 loaves, 6 for a friend of mine has arrived on a journey and I have nothing to set before him.' And he will answer from within, 'Do not bother me. The door is now shut and my children are with me in bed. I cannot get up and give you anything.' I tell you, though he will not get up and give him anything because he is his friend, yet because of his situation, he will rise and give him whatever he needs. And I tell you, ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and it will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives, and he who seeks finds, and to him who knocks it will be opened." In today's reading, we reflect on asking for something of someone, and it reflects the feeling that we have that sometimes God is not listening to us, or that he's not answering the prayers that we are asking. There are many occasions that Jesus taught us to pray. He himself went into the desert during this time, known as Lent, for a time of reflection and prayer. In many ways, prayer defines our relationship with God. The way in which we communicate is important too. Setting aside a time and a place to spend with God, where it can be fixed into our daily routines, where we know that we won't get distracted or disturbed by anyone, is a good idea. There are many reasons why people pray, sometimes for themselves or for others. We may share our prayer times with family, friends, and communities. Prayers are often devotional, giving praise and thanks. Prayers are often regarded as a way of asking for personal intercessions or for global issues. Petitionary prayers are a way to present requests to God. It's a way of communicating and sharing our anxieties with God. People find that prayers can provide a space of peace in their daily busy lives, and can have a calming effect if they are anxious about something. They are a way of dealing with conflict. Most of the religious traditions in the world feature prayer as a way of communicating with God. Prayers can be said sitting, standing, prostrating, kneeling, and walking. In some traditions, such as Sufism, some believers swirl the whole body around as a form of communication with the divine. Quakers, a Christian denomination, pray in silence. Prayer as an act of service, as Saint Teresa of Calcutta just demonstrated to us so well, is also considered a form of praise and worship. Music and hymns are also a form of prayer. Prayers may be recited or from direct and personal conversation with God. prayers ultimately remind people of their dependency on God. Often, we forget to thank God for the things He has provided. We take things for granted and find it difficult to be grateful for what we have. We give up easily when our demands are not met, and we grumble and complain because we have not had our wishes fulfilled. Maybe that you feel that God is not answering your prayers. You can always find support on CCR TV every day, 7 days a week, 24 hours of the day. You'll find others. Join in praise, worship, and prayer. Ask a friend, family member, or neighbor to pray for your intention. Ask for their help or advice. And even if they can't help, ask them to tune into CCR TV for inspiration. In sharing our concerns, we can lessen our burden and can reach out to the community. Our over-reliance and responsibility, we need to take action rather than waiting for God. Over-reliance of God's response to human needs are counterproductive, as God has an overall understanding of our needs. In the words attributed to St. Francis of Assisi, it's for giving in that we receive. And our prayer today is for our own personal intention and is a prayer that Jesus taught us in His own words on how to pray. Please do join us together as we say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thank you for joining us again today on this Lenten journey. As we conclude, we should consider that there is always so much to contemplate and so little time.